Guys, it's day 6 and it's 10 a.m. in the morning. As you must be aware that yesterday Keval's clutch plate got worn out, and that's the reason we have decided to tow his bike up to Leh. I tried riding his bike for a few kilometers, but it was really difficult because it's a steep uphill. So I have decided to tow his bike with Chitrang's bike. Reason being that Chitrang's bike is a 500cc engine and it will be easy to tow the bike with his bike. Keval is struggling at the moment. I need to tow him. Here we go. Yes. Don't worry, bro. I'll tow you up to Leh. In the morning, the bike was inspected by a mechanic and he concluded that the clutch plate was actually worn out. We asked him to repair the bike. He said he will not be able to do so as spare parts of Pulsar is not available in this area. So guys, can you imagine that Pulsar being one of the most common bikes in India and there is no spare parts available? He said spare parts of only Enfield is available in this area. And that's the reason I would like to suggest to all my fellow riders that whenever you take a trip to Ladakh, please come in Enfield so that you will not face a condition that currently we are facing. Not because Enfield is comfortable or it has a fan following or something. Just to avoid such kind of a scenario. Don't forget to carry all essential spare parts on your journey. So I'm going to tow his bike for the next 250 kilometers up to Leh. It sounds impossible, but it's not impossible, I feel. It's difficult, but it's not impossible. Keval is struggling again. Don't worry, bro. I'm there right behind you. And I'll make sure you reach Leh safe and sound. Here we go. My leg is slipping again and again because of the terrain. Here we go. I always thought that a trip to Leh Ladakh would be full of challenges. But this one is really eccentric. But I really believe deep within my heart that we will make it to Leh Ladakh together, safe and sound. Yes, that's what I believe. Keval's bike needs limited assistance because we are at the downhill right now. But still, I'm going to give him a little push so that we speed up a little. We are at the downhill of Gatha Loops, the famous Gatha Loops, which is famous because of its ghost, which haunts this particular place. Don't get afraid of the story, but it's true. Several years ago, there was a truck driver who was crossing this highway, and the truck was basically the last truck on this road, and it was too late for him to take the Srinagar Leh highway, which was still comparatively safer. So after Rohtang, it started snowing heavily. The driver somehow managed to bring the truck safely here at Gatha Loops, and suddenly the truck broke down and came to a complete halt. The driver couldn't fix the particular problem of this truck, and he decided to walk to a nearby village to get some help over there. Cleaner of the truck was, however, very ill and could barely walk, so he decided to stay back at the truck. Also, the truck couldn't be abandoned because it was loaded, and that's the reason the cleaner stayed back. It started to snow heavily and it became impossible for the truck driver to come back from that particular village, and for several days the cleaner was stranded at this place. After a few days, the cleaner, when the truck driver came back with some help, they found that the cleaner had died. He had eventually died of thirst, hunger and cold. The body of the cleaner was buried at gata loops by the villagers, right at the spot where it died. The very next year, the highway reopened. People started noticing a very strange thing. A beggar used to come and ask for water. The people who offered a water bottle, the hand of the beggar used to pass through the water bottle and the bottle used to just fall down. And the people who didn't offer used to face mountain sickness on the road ahead. Scary, isn't it? People then made a temple out here and started offering water bottles at this temple. And slowly, slowly, complaints started decreasing. I think Chitran's bike, his luggage is slipping down. Let me see. The right side is fine. Yes, it seems fine. Yeah, even the left side. Yes, it seems fine. There are riders coming back from Leh. There are a few riding groups who decide to take the Srinagar-Leh highway. And they take the Manali-Leh highway while coming back from Leh. Let's see when we reach. It's already 5:30 PM right now. You see there are campsites there. I hope to get some tea or coffee there because it's getting really cold. Oh my god, the roads are really bad. I wonder why BRO doesn't maintain the roads, because in spite of the fact that these roads are regularly taken by tourists, at least apart from the winter season. So guys, we'll be halting here for a few minutes, signing off for now. So guys, we are resuming the journey. We spoke to a few people in the camp and they told us that the road ahead is not as difficult as it was on the gata loops. We hopefully would be in a better position to tow Cable's bike up there. The only challenging part would be the Taglanga Pass, which is the world's second highest motorable road, the Taglanga Pass. I don't know how we'll be climbing the Taglanga Pass with Cable's bike. Nevertheless, when we have decided, we have to do it. I think Anthony's checking his engine oil. So we're really excited to do the Taglanga Pass. Let's see how it goes. Also, we realized that we have already entered the Ladakh region. We have actually entered the Ladakh region since we started from Sarchu. Sarchu being the border of Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh. So riding to Ladakh wouldn't be this difficult once the tunnel between Rohtang Pass and Leh is open. It will probably open in the year 2019. Like you, be strong to hold the powers of the sun. To dream, believe in strength. Now I'm the only one, only one. Superhero, superhero.
few kilometers and we are still struggling with Keval's bike.
I don't know how we will make it to Leh because our stamina is slowly and slowly decreasing. Keval is struggling again. Here you go, Keval. Come on, boy. This is the first time in my life that I am towing a bike for such a long distance and in such rough terrain. You can see the camps over there where we just stopped for tea. Here we go. You're a superhero. You're a superhero. It's 6:30 p.m. and we are just 150 kilometers away from Leh. We just located, we just found a backup van here in Lachulangla Pass. Keval wanted to ask for help here, but I really doubt that they would help us because they have their own cycles to carry on that backup van. He wanted to try his luck. I want to try my luck on a selfie. As expected, they said no because they have their own cycles to carry in that backup van. It's very difficult to find help in this particular road, and that's the reason people suggest you to take the Srinagar Leh highway, which is much safer than this road. There's some snow on the road, some white patches. We could locate snow after a long distance actually. But if you come here in the month of October, November, December, or should I say during the winters, the whole area, the whole road is cladded with snow. And I just use the words come here in the month of October, November, December, but then I don't think you will be able to come here in those months because the roads are closed. If and only if you have a helicopter to directly come and land here. This is a very risky journey to take. You have to carry each and every spare parts. The only thing that we didn't carry is a clutch plate. And see what happened to us. Anthony has stopped and Chitrang is also right ahead him. I think they were waiting for us.
We just wanted to rest for some time. We are resuming the journey shortly. Just look at the beauty of this place, guys. You see the tall, huge mountain over there? Oh my god, it looks humongous. Part of this mountain has been cut just to ensure that the vehicles pass by. I thought of stopping here for some pictures. Let's see how it comes out to be. It feels amazing to be here in Ladakh. I really can't explain how it feels. We can see a few more riders coming back from Ladakh. We are planning to halt somewhere ahead, maybe at another campsite. So, signing off for now.
We have come across an amazing road right now. Just that you see in the Bajaj Avenger ad, the Feel Like God ad. I don't know if it was this road or the NH1, but I'm glad the potholes and the rocks have finally gone and we have a straight highway in front of us. It's now easier for Cable to ride his bike as well. We are planning to click some good photographs here. Cable is standing there right in front to click a slow-mo. Let's see how it comes out to be. We waited to click some good photographs here, but Anthony has disappeared. Normally, Anthony is not interested to click photographs because he just wants to ride. He just wants to ride ahead and ahead. And he just doesn't stop. He even cannot hear the horn when we keep on honking to make him stop, but he's just not interested to stop. You see, I'm honking right now. He cannot hear me. Upar se he has a 500cc and it's a little difficult for me to catch him on a 350cc. Somehow I'm managing. रुक जा मेरे भाई रुक जा. ओह फाइनली रुका जाके. I'll sign off and click some nice photographs here. After riding for a few kilometers, we decided why not record a footage keeping the action camera facing backside. So we are going to try it right now, but this can be done only with a head mount and not a chin mount. Let's see how the footage comes out. We'll be soon approaching the famous Taglanga Pass, which is the world's second highest motorable road. I hope to reach Leh today by evening before sunset. Let's see, time will say, but I have to sign off as my camera battery is dying. So goodbye guys, see you on day 7. Signing off.